This is part 6 of Parabolas. In this video, we cover graphing functions in the form y equals a x minus h squared plus k. We graph these two functions, and we also state the vertex axis of symmetry and do rough sketches of these two other functions. All right, we're going to put it all together now. Let's say we have a function in this form, f of x equals 1 half x plus 1 squared minus 3. This actually is a really nice form for graphing a quadratic. And here's how it works. We can determine the vertex. That would be negative 1, negative 3. Remember, you decide what's in the parentheses. What makes that a 0 if x is negative 1? And of course, if x is negative 1, then you're going to have 1 half a 0 squared. So 0 minus 3 is just going to give you that other number over there. Negative 3. So we've got the vertex. The axis of symmetry, I'm going to call that AOX, is the line x equals negative 1. Remember, these always match. The x coordinate of the vertex, and for the axis of symmetry, what that number is going to be. Now, what else do we know with this 1 half? Well, it's a positive number in front of the x squared, right? So it's going to open up. And since it's 1 half, right, that's less than 1, the absolute value is less than 1, it's going to be a wide parabola. So what we could do is say, well, let's see, I know it's going to open up and be kind of wide. I know the vertex is here at negative 1, negative 3, and you could just, there's your rough sketch right there. You know it's going to look something like that, right? All right, so now let's go to it. How are we going to do that over on this graph? Well, the first thing I always do is either draw a line for the axis of symmetry or the vertex. It doesn't matter which you do first. So let's go ahead and put a dotted line at the axis of symmetry with x equals negative 1, because that's our axis of symmetry. And the vertex is always a point on the axis of symmetry. And that is going to be negative 1, negative 3. So there's the vertex right here. We know it's going to go up, and we know it's going to be wide by 1 half. This is how I do it. I actually just pretend that's like 0, 0, and I go, I would normally go over 1 and up 1, but this 1 half means I'm going to go half as high as usual. So I'm going to go over 1 and up 1 half, and then there's a corresponding point on the other side. Usually, for y equals x squared, you go over 2 and up 4, but you only want to go up half of 4. So you go over 2 and up 2, right? Half of 4. And then there's a corresponding one on the other side. Normally you go 3, 9, but instead we're going to go half a 9. So we're going to go up 4 and a half. 1, 2, 3, 4 and a half. And a corresponding point on the other side. Now, if we did 4, you would go over 4 and up 16, but you're going to go half a 16. So you can go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Depends how detailed and accurate you want to get. And there's a 1 on the other side. The more points you have, the easier it is to draw the parabola. And this is our parabola. Now, do you have to do it that way? Absolutely not. If you want, you could simply plug in a bunch of ordered pairs. Pick any number you want for x, and you could evaluate it. You know, just plug in negative 5, negative 4, negative 3, negative 2, negative 1, 0, 1, 2, 3. You got to get enough points so that you can find where that turning point is, where your vertex is. But you could certainly make a table of ordered pairs and connect it that way. But in any case, you do need to know what the vertex is and the axis of symmetry anyway. Okay, so now we're going to just write this down in general. Okay, so graphing functions in the form f of x equals a x minus h squared plus k. This is a nice form. A tells you whether it goes up or down. If it's positive, it goes up. If it's negative, it goes down. A also, at the bottom here, 4, tells you if the absolute value of A is greater than 1, it's going to be a steeper parabola. Otherwise, it's going to be a wider parabola. The vertex is hk, and the axis of symmetry is x equals h. And the way I do it is I start with a vertex, and I pretend that's where my origin is. I just pretend like that's the origin. And then I use the same point, the ordered pairs, for y equals x squared. All right, so you ready to do one? All right, here's for one for you to do. Graph f of x equals negative 2, x plus 3 squared plus 8, as accurate as possible on a piece of graph paper. And then state and label the vertex, the equation, write the equation of the axis of symmetry and label that on the graph. State whether the parabola opens up or down, and whether it's wider or steeper than f of x equals x squared. So go ahead and put the video on pause and try that. Okay, let's go for it. Vertex. All right. X would have to be negative 3 to make what's in parentheses 0, right? So it's negative 3, and that's going to help you with axis symmetry. That means x is going to be negative 3. So the vertex is negative 3, 8. Remember? This number stays the same. It's the opposite of what you see here, the plus 3. And that was supposed to be AOS for axis of symmetry. All right, so it says to label it. So we need to go over here and draw a dotted line, and we're just going to call that the axis symmetry, x equals 3 in a minute. Let's label the vertex. Negative 3, 8 is up here. Okay, so this is the axis symmetry, x equals negative 3. Okay, you dot the axis symmetry. All right, now it's got a negative 2, so this is going to open downward, right? Opens down. And let's see, the coefficient negative 2, well, absolute value of negative 2 is 2. That's bigger than 1, so this is going to be steep. So I just pretend this is my xy axis. Instead of going over 1 and down 1, I'm going to go over 1 and down 2. Every number is going to be doubled. Instead of going over 2, 4, remember you just do 2, 2, 2, and 2 squared, which is 4. So instead of going 2, 4, you're going to go 2, 8. So you're going to go over 2 and down 8. 2, 4, 6, 8. All right, what about 3? If you go over 3, you'd normally go 9. Well, if you double that, you're going to have to go down 18. Well, there's 8. And 8, okay, I can't even get that on the graph. So this gives me a pretty good idea of what this parabola is doing. And there we go. We've got f of x equals negative 2, x plus 3 squared plus 8. Now, parabolas are not always in that form. If it's in that form, it's easier to tell what the axis of symmetry is and to tell what the vertex is, but not everyone is going to be in that form. So keep in mind, we're doing it if it's in the form where we have an a, then an x plus or minus some number, right, squared, and then plus or minus some number. It might just be negative 2x squared, right, which you could think of as x plus 0 squared. There might not be a plus number, but that would be plus 0. But if it's in the form just ax squared plus bx plus c, that's different. That's what we'll be working on in the next video. All right, so let's just look at one more thing here. All right, for each function, state if the parabola opens up or down, and state the vertex and equation of the axis symmetry, and then we're going to do a tiny sketch, and I'll show you what I mean. Not a real sketch. All right, so for the first one, is this open up or down? Well, it's negative 3, so it opens down. All right. What's the vertex? Okay, well, the x has got to be negative 5, and that means the y has got to be negative 7. What's the equation of the axis symmetry? It's just x equals that x coordinate here. X equals negative 5. It's a vertical line. So what's the sketch? Well, it opens down. It has a vertex at negative 5, negative 7, and it goes down. I didn't ask you whether it was going to be steep or wide, but the negative 3 means it's going to be steep. All right, next one. Up or down? Well, 2/5 is positive, so it goes up. What's the vertex? Notice I didn't write x minus h. Well, that means that the y value is just 0, because you could think of that as x minus 0. 0, 6 is the vertex. And the axis symmetry then is just the y-axis, x equals 0. So this one, wherever the vertex, if that's 0, 6, it's going to go up. 2/5 means it's going to be y. Didn't ask about that, but, you know, it should be a more wide parabola. So before even getting out your, you know, paper, it's going to be able to go ahead and get at least the rough idea of what it looks like.